मैथमेटिक्स क्लास 11 चैप्टर 14 मैथमेटिकल रीजनिंग. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड एक्सरसाइज 14.3. टुडे वी शैल स्टडी इम्प्लीकेशंस, कॉन्ट्रापॉजिटिव एंड कन्वर्स ऑफ अ स्टेटमेंट एंड एक्सरसाइज 14.4. इम्प्लीकेशंस. वी शैल स्टडी द इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ इफ देन, ओनली इफ एंड ओनली इफ. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ नंबर वन, इफ देन. If P, then Q says that in the event, if P is true, then Q must be true. Now, in mathematical statement, if there is if then, this means that the first statement we call it as a P. If it is true, then the second statement that we call it as Q must be true. Let us take an example. Statement R, if you are born in some country, then you are citizen of that country. Now this is a compound statement. It has got two component statements. So corresponding two statements, the first one I call it as P from here. You are born in some country. And the second statement I call it Q from here. Q, you are citizen of that country. So it is very clear that if P is true, if you are born in the country, then automatically it will become the citizen of that country, right? So P is true implies Q must be true. Okay, that is the meaning of if then. If P, then Q does not say anything or no demand on Q when P is false. Now suppose in if P then Q, in that statement, if suppose the first statement Q is false, sorry, P is false, then you cannot say anything about the second statement, that is Q. Example, if you are not born in the country, then you cannot say anything about Q. So if you are not born in the country, that is the first statement is false, then you cannot say anything about the Q, that is whether you are citizen or not citizen. Okay, that is not happening of P has no effect on happening of Q. So if P is not happening, that it will not affect the happening of Q. If P then Q is the statement does not imply that P happens. So if P then Q, this also means that it does not imply that P happens. P implies Q is denoted by P implies Q. So this is the notation we use for P implies Q. P is sufficient condition for Q. If P then Q, in that P, the first statement is the sufficient condition for Q. P only if Q. Now in this, to understand this, I will take one example. Statement R, if a number is multiple of 9, then it is multiple of 3. What does this mean? This says that a number is multiple of 9 only if it is multiple of 3. Okay, so here the meaning of if P then Q means P only if Q, right? So here the statement, from this statement we can say that the number is multiple of 9 only if it is multiple of 3. Q is not necessary condition for P. Now in this, if P then Q, Q is not a necessary condition. But P is a sufficient condition for Q, right? But Q is not necessary condition for P. For the same example, let us try to understand this statement. Okay, so I'll write the statement P from here. A number is multiple of 9, and Q from here, a number is multiple of 3. That is, when a number is multiple of 9, it is not necessarily a number of necessarily multiple of 3. Okay, so it does, this is what means that the Q is not the necessary condition. Okay, that Q is this one, a number is multiple of 3, so it is not necessarily multiple of 3, right? So Q is not the necessary condition. Not Q implies not P. That is, if a number is not multiple of 3, then it is not a multiple of 9. Okay, so not Q means negation of this. That is, a number is not multiple of 3, right? And negation, not P means negation of this statement. That is, then it is not multiple of 9. Contrapositive and converse. The contrapositive of a statement P implies Q is the statement not Q implies not P. So if you are writing the contrapositive of a statement P implies Q, then the contrapositive will be not Q implies not P. Okay, you can see this example, the example which I took before here. That was, if a number is multiple of 9, then it is multiple of 3. Okay, this is a statement. So here P implies Q. Now suppose you want to write the contrapositive of it, right? So here the first statement I write PS, a number is multiple of 9, okay? That is the first statement I call Q, and the second is P, first one is P and second one is Q, a number is multiple of 3. Now we want to write the contrapositive, that means not Q implies not P, right? So this negation of this, that is, if a number is not multiple of 3, then it is the negation of the first statement, that is P is not a multiple of 9, right? So this is a example of a contrapositive. And converse, if you want to write the converse of a statement, then it means that the converse of a statement P implies Q is the statement Q implies P. So P implies Q, the converse of this will be Q implies P, right? P implies Q together with its converse, that is Q implies P, gives you if and only if. This is the other implication, right? So if P implies Q and Q implies P, that means P implies if and only if Q. Okay, or you can say it is if and only P if and only if Q. That is what the implication. Let us take the example for the first one, that is for contrapositive. If a triangle is equilateral, it is isosceles. So contrapositive means not Q implies not P. So this is Q and this is your P, right? So this not implies not this one. So if a triangle is not isosceles, then it is not equilateral. Let us take the example for the converse of a statement. Example, if a number n is even, then n square is even. So this is a statement, we have to write the converse of this. Then converse, the definition is Q implies P. So first statement is P, second statement is Q. So now converse will be Q implies P. So I will start from here. If a number n square is even, then the P will be n is even. So this is the converse. Second implication, if and only if. The symbol we use is double implies. Okay. And actually already I gave you the definition from here, that if P implies Q together with its converse, Q implies P gives you if and only if, right? So that is the second implication. Now here I'm just writing the symbol which we use, okay? But this is the meaning, right? If and only if means this statement, okay? Now here the symbol we use is double implies, and it means that P if and only if Q and Q if and only if P, right? So this is what means the if and only if. P if and only if Q means P if and only if Q and Q if and only if P. P is necessary and sufficient condition for Q and vice versa. So in this, P is necessary and sufficient condition for Q, and similarly Q also is necessary and sufficient condition for P. That is the meaning of vice versa. P double implies Q. Okay, this symbol just using. Let us take the example. A rectangle is square if and only if all its four sides are equal. Okay, we can write this P implies Q and Q implies P. Okay, so the first I can write as if a rectangle is square, then all its four sides are equal. So I am writing if then. Okay, and second one, if all four sides of a rectangle are equal, then a rectangle is a square. Right, so here P if and only if Q. So this means P if and only if Q and Q if and only if P. That is a if and only if means, right? So this is the implication. Exercise 14.4. Question number 1. Rewrite the following statement with if then in 5 different ways conveying the same meaning. So you are given a statement and you have to write the same statement with if then in 5 different ways, but the meaning should be same. If natural number is odd, then its square is also odd. Okay, so this statement we have to write in 5 different ways. So we can write here, a natural number is odd implies its square is odd. Okay, we already said that P implies Q. Okay, it also means that if P then Q. Second way you can write as, a natural number is odd only if its square is odd. Okay, this also we have studied that P only if Q. This also means, if P then Q. Okay, so that's what I am using. A natural number is odd only if its square is odd. So only if I am using, right? Third way you can write as, for a natural number to be odd, it is necessary that its square is odd. Okay, so that is what I am using, that the necessary condition. Four, for a square of a natural number to be odd, it is sufficient that the number is odd. Okay, so this is like using the sufficient condition. And fifth way you can write it as, If the square of a natural number is not odd, then the natural number is not odd. Okay, this is not P, sorry, not Q implies not P, right? So we have written in five ways which have got the same meaning. Question number two, write the contrapositive and converse of the following. Roman number one, if x is prime, then x is odd. So this is given to you a statement. You have to write contrapositive and you have to write the converse of it. Now remember, the definition is contrapositive is you have to write not Q implies not P, right? And converse will be Q implies P. So you should know what is P and what is Q. Okay, so that is the definition I gave you before. So let us write here. So here call the first statement as the P and the second statement, that is x is odd, will be Q. Okay, so let us write the contrapositive. So contrapositive is not Q implies not P, right? So here this is my Q. So this you have to start with this, but negation of this implies the not P, that is implies negation of the first one. So I write if x is not odd, here x is odd, so I write x is not odd, then you have to write x is prime, no? So negation of that, that is x is not prime, right? It is very simple. And the converse will be converse will be P implies Q, converse of that will be Q implies P, right? So you have to start from here. So we can say converse as if X is an odd number, okay, I'm starting from here, then X is prime number, that is the converse. Roman number two, if the two lines are parallel, then they do not intersect in the same plane. So first contrapositive, the first statement you call it as a P, right, up to here, and they do not intersect, you call it as a Q. So contrapositive is, first you have to write not Q implies not P. So I write here, if two lines intersect, this one, in the same plane, here not intersect, I write negation of that, that is not just omit. So intersect in the same plane, then they are not parallel. Here they are parallel, here they are not parallel. And converse will be Q implies P. If the two lines do not intersect, from here I am starting, in the same plane, then they are parallel, right? So this is a converse. Roman number three, something is cold implies that it has low temperature. The contrapositive will be, the first one is P, second one is Q. So contrapositive is not Q implies not P. So contrapositive of this will be, if something does not have low temperature, then it is not cold. Converse will be Q implies P. If something has low temperature, then it is cold. Roman number four, you cannot comprehend geometry if you do not know how to reason deductively. Contrapositive, if you know to reason deductively, then you can comprehend geometry. The converse will be, if you do not know how to reason deductively, then you cannot comprehend geometry. Roman number five, x is an even number implies that x is divisible by 4. Okay, so first statement is P, second is Q. So contrapositive will be not Q implies not P. So negation of this and negation of this, right? So let us write contrapositive. If from here x is not divisible by 4, then x is not an even number. Okay, negation of this. And converse will be Q implies P. So Q means from here. If x is divisible by 4, then x is an even number. Okay, I hope you understand question number 2. Question number 3. Write each of the following in the form if then. Roman number 1. You get a job implies that your credentials are good. We have to write if then form. Okay, so this means if you get a job, then your credentials are good. Okay, it is direct question. Direct answer you can write. Roman number 2, the banana trees will bloom if it stays warm for a month. Okay, so you have to use if then. So what you can say, if it stays warm for a month, then the banana trees will bloom. Roman number 3, a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its diagonals bisect each other. So we can write it as, if the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. Roman number 4, to get an A plus in the class, you do all the exercises of the textbook or of the book. If you get A plus in the class, then you do all the exercises of the book. Okay, so that is a if then. So this is the answer for question number 3. Only you have to write the given statements using if then. Question number 4. Identify as contrapositive or converse. So question A is, if you live in a Delhi, in Delhi, then you have winter clothes. Now the two statements are given to us and we have to say whether they are contrapositive or converse. Okay, so for this they have given us these two statements. If you do not have winter clothes, then you do not live in Delhi. Now here, see, in this statement there are two statements, right? One is, if you live in Delhi, that means you live in a Delhi, that is P, right? And this one, you have winter clothes, that is Q. Now what you have written here is, if you do not have winter clothes, so this is not Q, right? You have winter clothes, negation of this is not Q, that is you do not have winter clothes, then you do not live in a Delhi, and here the statement is you live in a Delhi, so it is negation of this. So not Q implies not P, that means this is a contrapositive. And Roman number 2 is given for part A is, if you have winter clothes, then you live in Delhi. So it is like, this is my statement Q implies statement P. So if for the statement P implies Q, if you can write as Q implies P, then that is called your converse. So this is a converse, right? So this is a converse and this is a contrapositive. Number B, if a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then its diagonals bisect each other. Now for this, Roman number 1 is, if the diagonals of a quadrilateral do not bisect each other, then the quadrilateral is not a parallelogram. Now in this given statement, from this, a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, call it as P, right? And the second one is, its diagonals bisect each other, that is Q, right? Now here what we have got here, here is diagonals bisect each other. It is starting here is, the diagonals do not bisect, that means negation of the statement Q. And here another part is, quadrilateral is not a parallelogram, so negation of P. So not Q implies not P, that means this is a contrapositive of the given statement. Roman number 2 is, if the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. And this is a converse. Why converse? Because here it is Q implies P. Q is this statement, right? Diagonals bisect. So diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other and implies P. That is, P is quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So it implies then the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So this becomes converse. So this is contrapositive and this is a converse, right? I hope you understand this exercise. We end the exercise over here. We keep this much for today. Thank you very much.